Hi, and welcome to Aloha Authentic. I'm your host, Kamaka Pili. On today's show, we're here at Kawaiahaʻo Church to speak of the introduction of Christianity to Hawaii. Fascinating fact, Kawaiahaʻo Church is made up of some 14,000 slabs of coral, all hand chiseled underwater and hauled to this location. Did you know? Now you do. Welcome to the inside of Kawaiahaʻo Church, the oh so majestic stone church here on Oahu. I'm very honored to introduce the Kahu of Kawaiahaʻo, Uncle Kenneth Makuakāne. Thank you very much for your time, Uncle.
Aloha mai kaua.
I'm really excited for our conversation. But before we get into that, of course, we have our protocol, our umeke, our bowl of poi is open on the table because, you know, Tutu used to always say when the bowl of poi is open on the dinner table, you know, talk stink, you know, talk negative, you talk positive because that bad energy will spoil the food and you don't like eat them. And in our conversation today, we're speaking of the introduction of Western religion and faith here in Hawaii, really. And again, Uncle, thank you for being the person to help and speak towards this.
Oh, I know, that's kind of interesting that you call it Western religion because Western religion is in Connecticut. So we're Westerer than they are. So when does the West turn into the East?
I always wondered that when people refer to the West, who are you actually talking about?
I know.
Because I think West meets East kind of by Hawaii.
There we go, and that's where we are.
I do want to pinpoint one thing. We are shooting in December right before Christmas. That's why we have the beautiful Christmas. Thank you for setting up the Christmas decorations.
Oh, though, only for you though.
Yeah, we're gonna take them down after. But Kawaiahaʻo, so here on Oahu, this is the first Protestant church. When was the arrival of the missionaries? And tell us a little bit of this, you know, that story leading to the establishment
sure.
of Kawaiahaʻo.
Sure. So in 1819, is October 23rd, I believe, of 1819 is when the missionaries left Long Harbor in Boston. And then they came to Hawaii in it was established in April 4th out in Makuakāne Church, but they landed in March 30th of 1820. So they stopped in Kona, and then they came here 2 weeks later and established this church on Oahu. And then 2 weeks later, they went to Waimea on Kauai and established the Waimea Church. So there were three churches that were established in that first year.
This church is really interesting. As we mentioned at the top of the show, this is all made of coral.
Yes.
Where did all this coral come from?
I'll give you one guess. Come on.
I would say Ala Moana.
Well, Ala Moana, but it went all the way out to Waianae.
Really?
I mean, yes, they had so much kane that had to dive down. Now, this is the 1830s without aqualung and any of that kind of stuff. So it was free diving. So we have, what, over 14,000, 1,000 block.
That's crazy.
Coral pieces that made this building.
And that's where the nickname, the Stone Church,
yes.
came from.
But it's not actually stone, it's coral.
That's true. You know, that's fascinating because this has been the center, kind of like a community center at the same time as being a church at that time.
We keep thinking because today's society, we compartmentalize. You got to be this and not this and this and this and this. But in those days, it was everything because it was the largest building. So it helped to establish a faith community here in Honolulu. It also is where the government, you know, it's the center where government was held. And so they came inside here to have their legislative sessions. It was here that people got married. It was here that people got laid to rest and, you know, all of our li'i were put to, laid in state here, and many, many other kinds of functions because this was the center of town.
I do want to pinpoint and just to help to educate, I think a lot of people say Kawaiahaʻo rather than Kawaiahaʻo. But with that being said, what does Kawaiahaʻo mean?
The waters of Haʻo. So there was a princess Haʻo that used to come and bathe in the springs here at in this area. So you know that this Ahapua is Kona, and this area was called Kou, and this ili that is called Kawaiahaʻo now was because of that princess.
I've seen some pictures and some put-togethers in terms of like a diagram where this is actually just all dry, dusty land at the time compared to what we see now.
Oh, of course. You know, and obviously the topography was a lot different at the time. The water line was up further, mm-hmm. you know, and so what we see today is not really what happened 200 years ago when this first was established.
I think it's fascinating to learn more about that particular time of the arrival of the missionaries, as you have Hawaiian mission houses and the homes right behind here. So be sure to scan the QR code on the screen, because we actually have a web exclusive segment where we sit down with Hawaiian mission homes to learn more about the influence of the missionaries here in Hawaii.
Yep, sure. Because that was the Hale Kahu. For some reason, somebody put a road between us and the Hale Kahu. But that was the minister's house.
So this was all together?
They were all together.
And this isn't actually the original Kawaiahaʻo
church? No, this is the fifth
church.
This is the fifth iteration.
Really?
Yeah, because we had thatched roofs back then, you know? So it was the ohia post, and then you put the pili grass on.
Yeah.
But of course, you know, the wind come blow.
The test of time with all this weather and the phenomena that take place. I think it's fascinating. I do want to pinpoint that despite the fact that you're a kahu here, you're also a very accomplished Hawaiian musician.
You said it.
I did. But I want to continue on that conversation, because I think it's fascinating how you can be a practicing Hawaiian, a practitioner, and a practicing Christian at the same time. Can I ask you that coming up next?
Sure, but look, can I do something? Give me that card. Put it over here.
I have notes and nothing has ever stuck to that card. So coming up at the break, we'll dive deeper in that conversation of how religion and spirituality can coexist. Coming up right here on Aloha Authentic. Welcome back to Aloha Authentic. Again, we're here at Kawaiahaʻo Church with Kahu ke Makuakāne. Thank you again, Uncle, for taking the time. Wow. You know, you thought you pulled a sly one. As much as I don't stick to my notes, I need something to keep me on track. Many of these. Plus, I'm Portuguese. I need to have something in my hand because I don't know what else to do with it. I just keep doing this.
I'm not going to say anything.
You know, we ended off our last segment, which I really want to, I'm fascinated about this, of how you can be both a Hawaiian and a Christian at the same time. Because I get this question a lot, and I don't know what my answer is. Like, I have a feeling, I know how I feel about it, but I don't know how to put it into words. So if I pose you the question, how can you be a Hawaiian, a cultural practitioner, and a faithful Christian at the same time?
Okay, then I pose the same question to you. What is your first name?
Kamaka.
What does that mean?
The I.
Okay, so from a physical standpoint, we see this, but it can be the eye to your spirit, it can be the eye to your heart, it can be the eye to your Makuakāne, to your lineage. It can be the opening of a door that finds a new path. And so in the faith, when you say Kamaka, it just has this opening of another perspective. But not another, because it's probably the same perspective. Like, for instance, you know, I'm from Hilo. And so when I look at Mauna Kea, or even Mauna Loa, because it's erupting right now, you know, I see it from one place and I can tell you exactly how it looks. But my cousin from Waimea goes, no, cuz, the thing looks like this. Then my cousin from Kona goes, no, it looks like this. But if we put our collective together, we get the whole perspective of what these mauna look like. So when we put the name Kamaka together and we all give you our mana'o, then that is the total perspective of you. So the development of your character and your and you as an individual goes beyond just looking at you physically. It's looking into your eye of not just your mind, but the eye of your heart, your soul, not just the ike that you have, but the wisdom from which is gleaned from when you talk to me. That is what faith talks about. Is Kawaiahaʻo has never been about propping the church up, because the church is a building, but it is about having people find who they really are in their walk in life, and to make them understand the duality of their life as physical and spiritual. And that's what I believe is the kuleana, the responsibility of a caretaker, or the kahu, or like the kumu. Mm-hmm. We're kumu to help develop you so that you can understand yourself better.
Then with what you just said, are you saying that it's one in the same?
it is always one and the same. It is us as human beings that try to compartmentalize life. But it's all the gray area. Because just because we look different doesn't mean that we are different. Mm-hmm. Just because we think different doesn't mean that we don't value the other person's mana'o. Like how you talk about the poi. There's nothing we can say that will sour the poi if we respect each other and value each other's life. Mm. And that is what our walk in life is to do, is to say that we are all here in the same place at the same time to love on each other.
So then is there a difference between religion and spirituality?
Boy, you like getting controversial.
It's my specialty.
Let's put our feet up. Come on, let's put our feet up. Why did you take your shoes off?
Because I was raised to do so.
Exactly. That's spirituality. Because you came here knowing that where you stand is a holy and sacred ground. Just like how when we go up to the mauna, we take off our shoes because that's holy ground. That's a cultural thing. We come over here, and because it blends in, because we don't know the perspective of a particular religion doesn't mean that it doesn't exist within that structure. Because, you know, for us in our faith, there was a dude named Moses when he went up to Mount Sinai to go get the Ten Commandments. And what Kiakua said is, take off your sandals, because what you are stepping on is holy ground. So the culture and the religion, they mesh into each other, but we're trying to split them apart. So when you tell me, what's the difference between spirituality and religion? What's the difference between you and somebody else? What's the difference between you and the Kapanee and the Filipino, you know, and the Korean? There's nothing different. We may speak a little different. We may think a little different, but we are all valued because we are all resonating as part of life. And that's that spiritual being. And just because we cannot see it doesn't mean that we cannot feel it. I can feel the wind coming through me. I know when it's anuanu, when it's cold, I cannot see the wind. Can you?
No.
Exactly. So what are we fighting about?
You know, I do want to ask a question. I know we're coming up on time in terms of this segment, so I want to pose you a question that maybe then we go into the commercial and we come back out and we talk about that. But just recently, I did a story, speaking of Mauna Loa, mm-hmm. you know, when everything happened, I think Mauna Loa erupted on the same day, if not the day after snow fell. On Lakuʻoka, on top of that, Hawaiian Independence Day. But then also waking up with snow on top Mauna Kea, mm-hmm. which brings up a whole nother deity, because now everybody's talking about Pele, the goddess deity of fire and volcano, and then we have Poliahu, the deity of snow. So I want to ask you about that coming up after the break. So stick around, we'll have more on this very Ono conversation coming up right here on Aloha Authentic.
What do you think this ahu, or cape, was made from? Is it A, kapa, B, hau, C, animal hide, or D, shark skin? The answer when we return. What do you think this ahu or cape was made from? The answer is A, kapa. We commonly think of Hawaiian ahu as being made from feathers, such as ahu ula, but this special ahu is made from kapa, one of the few that Bishop Museum is aware of. The pink kapa is called pa'i ula in Hawaiian and refers to both the color and the process used to make it. The key to making pa'i ula is red cloth. When the kapa is still wet, pieces of red cloth are placed onto the wet material and then beaded. The result is a color transfer process where pink is visible on one side while white remains on the other. Did you know? Now you do.
Welcome back to Aloha Authentic. Once again, welcome back to Kawaiahaʻo Church with Kahu Ken Makuakāne. Uncle, you know, before we went in, pose the question. Your thoughts about telling stories of deities and goddesses such as Pele and Poliahu while being a Christian. What is your mana'o on that?
Okay, so you talk about westernized religion. Well, it didn't come from the United States, it didn't come from England, it came from further back and further back when you talk about the Middle East. So now you're talking about different cultures that are amalgamated and meshed and all this thing. And so what is the true so-called religion? Mm-hmm. So there are different iterations of it. But if you truly believe that there is a divine that was, is, and is to come, then you know that everything was created. So that means that it didn't happen only in that one spot of the world. That divine made everything. That means that the divine was over here from the very beginning of time. And it was everywhere else in every indigenous culture at the very same time. How that culture created the divine in their contextual form is how they developed their particular religion. So you had the question about what is the difference between religion and spirituality. I just believe that religion is the lowest form of spirituality. Because when you keep thinking that your God is better than somebody else's God, what are you trying to prove? I don't have to prove that my God is bigger, because I know my God is the best.
So it really comes down to keep yourself as an open book.
Oh, that's exactly right. You keep yourself as an open book.
Because the moment you close, then that's when you start pointing fingers that say, you're wrong because I'm right.
Right.
But just like Olelo, I mean, there's different dialects, different words to mean the same thing.
Yes.
But saying I to eat versus paina to eat, not right, one is right or wrong. You just keep yourself an open book, and then you know twice as much than you did before.
Oh, I know. When I was first going with my wife, we was arguing about what, because she's from Maui, I'm from Hawaii Island, and I used to always talk about hauʻuke uke, and she went, what's that? I said, and I showed her, she goes, oh, that's hauʻi ui. I went, no, the word's not hauʻi ui, it's hauʻuke uke. And she said, no, we opened the Pukui dictionary, get both words in there meaning the same thing. But that's exactly right. Until you leave the book open and find that both your and my expression is valued, that's what we're trying to do here. Not trying, but we are doing here. And that's what this place exemplifies, is that we're an open book. It's not a building with walls. We are a church without walls, because we are a people without walls. And that's what Aloha is. And if this Halipuli stands for Aloha, it means that there is no gap between me and the next person, me and the next government, me and the next world. Because if we think that the earth is the only place that exists, then again, we close the book. So we have to leave that book open so that the truth can be revealed to us in our walk, in our own time.
When people ask me that, how can you be both? I just think God wouldn't have never created cultures if you never had the chance to practice it.
Sure. We have this story about the Tower of Babel. I think everybody's heard about it, because everyone was trying to get to the top to get closer to God, the divine. But then,
that's when everybody spoke the same language.
They spoke the same language, and all of a sudden, he said, I don't get you. Poof! Don't you think is that when Olelo started? He made all the different languages, and he made us in our
that's
language
right.
too. But we're the same people. We started with the same language, and we're going to end up with the same language.
You know, I have to thank you, because the way you were able to share, you're very inclusive. And I appreciate that, and I'm hoping our viewers, because I can only assume there are people with a lot of different faith bases watching this show. But bringing it all back to Kawaiahaʻo Church, the role that this has served, I mean, it's been the church for how many years now, but does it still serve the same purpose, or what is the purpose you see Kawaiahaʻo being in its role today here in the community?
Wonderful question. So Kawi Keauli, Kamehameha III, in the early 1840s, when we regained our sovereignty once again, stood on the front steps of our church. And what did he proclaim in that front steps? Which means?
The way that we have it is the life of the land is perpetuated in righteousness.
Okay, so what is righteousness? When you look at a coin, and when you flip the coin, what is it? Heads or tails, right? That's right or wrong. But righteousness, sometimes the coin lands straight on the top. Righteousness is not looking for the right or wrong, but looking for the fair way of both of us being relevant. And that is the role of this church and every other church and every other faith group, or even just a bunch of people talking. Because this is called church. Church is this is just the building. You and I are doing church right now. We are relating to each other spiritually as well as physically. And so the idea is to keep everything pono, keep everything righteous, to say what you believe and what I believe may not exactly be the same, but can we still have aloha for each other? And if we allow aloha to guide our paths, then nothing else will get in the way. And this poibo always going to stay ono.
Well, Uncle, thank you very much. The way you made it is so fascinating and intriguing, and I couldn't have picked a better person to speak with, so thank you very much.
I can find one for you.
Stick around, we'll be right back right here on Aloha Authentic. Welcome back to Aloha Authentic. I hope you had enjoyed this conversation. I know this may ruffle some people's feathers, but Uncle, I think that's the whole point, right?
That is the whole point.
A conversation and from that point move forward in discussion.
And be pono in the way we talk to each other.
Be pono. Well, we can sit here and talk story all day, but here's a little makana that we have for you.
The least we can do.
You know, if people have watched this and now they're intrigued to find out more about Kawaiahaʻo, or maybe even come and visit one of your services.
Sure. Our services are on Sunday at 8:30 a.m. and then we also have kawaiahaʻochurch.com is our website.
Thank you very much, Uncle. For this episode, our featured artists, we're featuring a bakery called Beyond Pastries Bakery. It's a bakery and bake studio that is located in Honolulu, offering a wide range of breads, pastries, and signature desserts. Also hosting baking workshops for home bakers and baking enthusiasts, showcasing curated works of Hawaii's local ceramic artists. Be sure to visit their website and their social media handles to find out more. And if you aren't already doing so, be sure to follow Aloha Authentic. We have a lot more great conversations to come, so you can stay in tune with the latest. Mahalo again, Uncle. Thank you very much. Aloha. Ahui hou.